My dear P5 learners, welcome back to lesson 4 of this online teaching. My name is Mr. Mugisha Emmanuel. We're still going to take you through mathematics. In our previous lesson, I taught you how to expand numbers using place values, and I left you with an activity which I hope you sat down and did very well. But before I go to today's lesson, I want to go through two numbers of the activities which I gave you. And these two numbers are the numbers I expect you maybe to have got some challenges in expanding. That is G and H. So for G, we are supposed to expand 18,065 using place values. 18,065 using place values. So I told you, first identify the place value of each digit. 6 has a place value of 1s. Sorry, 5 has a place value of 1s. 6 has a place value of 10s. 0 has a place value of 1s, of 100s. And 8 has a place value of 1000s. Then 1 has a place value of 10,000. So having identified the place values, what do we do? We multiply each digit by the place value. The digit will have 1 times its place value, 10,000. Then plus 8 times its place value, which is 1,000. Then plus 0 times its place value, which is 100s. Then plus 6 times its place value, which is 10s. And 5 times its place value, which is 1s. So we write 1. So I expect you to have got this one. Then H, it is 636,573. Do the same, identify the place values. 3, 1s, 7, 10s, 5, 100s, 6, 1000s, then 3, 10,000, then 6, it is going to be 100,000. So it is digit times the place value, 6 times 100,000, then plus 3 times the place value, which is 10,000, then 6 times the place value, which is 1,000, plus 5 times the place value, which is 100, plus 7 times the place value, which is 10, then plus 3 times the place value, which is 1. Basically, this is what we looked at in our previous lesson. So again, I have come back with another interesting lesson, and that is expansion of whole numbers using values. Expansion of numbers using values. I think you still remember how to find values. The other time I told you that to get a value of a digit, you must get a digit times its place value. So basically, that's what we are going to look at in this lesson. So by the end of this lesson, I expect you to have learned how to expand numbers using values. I expect you to have learned how to expand numbers, and basically whole numbers, using values. So in our example number one, we are expanding this number, 4,672. 4,672. Okay? 4,672. Identify the place values of each digit. What is the place value of 2? 1s. What is the place value of 7? 10s. What is the place value of 6? 100s. What is the place value of 4? It is 1000s. So since we are expanding this number using values, get the value of 4, get the value of 6, get the value of 7, and the value of 2, then you add. That's what you want. So for that matter, we shall have 4 times the place value of 4, which is 100. Sorry, 1,000. Plus 6 times the place value, which is 100. Plus 7 times the place value, which is 10. Then plus 2 times the place value, which is 1. Do you remember this expansion? I told you that when you do this, you have expanded using place values. But do we need place values? No. We just need values. So what is the value of 4? It is going to be 4 times 1,000, which is going to give us 4,000. Plus 6 times 100, which is going to give us 600. Plus 7 times 10, the value is going to be 70. Plus 2 times 1, the value is going to be 2. Some children make mistakes. They go back, add this one, and they get back at the question. No, we are expanding. And when you are told to expand, please, you stop on the values. You stop on the values of each digit. So for this matter, you will realize that the value of 4 is 4,000. The value of 6 is 6,000. The value of 7 is 70. And the value of 2 is 2. I have expanded that number using values. Can we have another example? We are expanding this number, which is 53,694. 53,694. Okay? So we shall have 53,694. Write the place value of each digit. Ones, tens. Then this one will be hundreds. What about this one? Thousands. Then this one is going to be 10,000. 10,000. So what is the big deal here? We are expanding using values. And to get a value of a digit, you get a digit times the place value. Beginning with 5. The digit is 5 times its place value, which is 10,000. Plus 3 times its place value, which is 1,000. Plus 6 times its place value, which is 100. Plus 9 times its place value, which is now 10. Then plus 4 times its place value, which is 1. But we have been told to expand using values. Now, are these values? The answer is no. So can we go ahead and get values? What is the value of 5? 5 times 10,000, we are getting 50,000. Plus, what is the value of 3? That is 3 times 1,000, which is going to give me 3,000. Plus, what is the value of 6? It is going to be 6 times 100, which is 600. Plus 9 times the place value, which is 10, which is going to give us 90. And 4 times 1, what do we get? We are getting 4. For this matter, we have expanded using values. Why? The value of 5 is 50,000. The value of 3 is 3,000. The value of 6 is 6,000. And the value of 9 is 90. And the value of 4 is 4. Therefore, I have expanded my number using values. Okay? I have expanded my number using values. Let's have one more example. See, we are expanding 746,297. We are expanding 746,297. Step 1, identify the press value of each digit. So we have 7, 4, 6, 2, 9, 7. Begin from your right. 7, 1s. 9, it is in tens. 2, hundreds. 6, thousands. Then 4, 10,000. And 7 is in 100,000. So we are going to get the values. How do we get values? Digit times the place value. So we shall have 7 times its place value, 100,000. Plus 4 times its place value, which is 10,000. Plus 6 times its place value, which is 1,000. Plus 2 times its place value, which is 100. 9 times its place value, which is 10. So we multiply by 10. And finally, 7 times the 1s, which is the place value. So I have now expanded using place values. But the question is, expand using values. Can we go ahead and get the place values? I mean the values. The value of 7 will be 700,000. And the value of 4 will be 40,000. And the value of 6 is going to be 600. The value of 2 will be, this one is 6,000. The value of 2 is going to be 200. The value of 9 is going to be 90. And the value of 7 is going to be 7. So I have expanded my number using values. Okay? I've expanded my number using values. So what is very important about this is you to know the expansion which is required. The moment you know that you are supposed to expand this one using this one, you will not get problems. We began by place values, whereby we are multiplying by the place value. We have gone ahead to get the values. The values are here. So I don't expect you to go ahead, add, and get back the answer. We are not here to prove. But to prove this one when expanded using this one, you will get back at this one. No, we are not here to prove, but to expand. And my expanded number is here. Having taken you through 3 examples, there is a child there who is saying, "Teacher, give us one more last example so that we don't mess up with your work." And indeed, I'm going to do that. I'm going to give you one last example, because I don't want to leave anybody who would say, "Oh, teacher, I do not understand. I think this last example is going to make you understand. So C, then this one is D. What are we expanding? We are expanding 4, 3, 2, 6. Okay? So how do we read this one? 4,326. We are expanding it using values. So we need to get the value of 4, the value of 3, the value of 2, the value of 6. Ah, we have expanded. So we have 4, 3, 2, 6. Place values of each digit. This one is 1s. This one is 10s. This one is 100s. This one is 1,000s. So a digit times the place value, 4 times z, the place value, which is 1,000, plus 3 times the place value, which is 100, then plus 2 times the place value, which is 10, then plus 6 times the place value, which is 1. So having done that one, I need to take another step whereby we shall get the values. So the value of 4 will be 4 times 1,000, which is 4,000. 3 times 100, which is 300. 2 times 10, which is 20, and 6 times 1, which will give you 6. And this one would be our expanded number using values. I want to thank you so much for being good learners. Thank you so much for enjoying this lesson with me. I have remained Mr. Mugisha Emmanuel. I'm going to leave you with an activity of again 8 numbers, which I expect you to sit down and write so well. Bye-bye.